Praise the Lord. Good morning from wherever you are watching me from. It is a good week. It's a good day, beginning of the week. I want to thank God so much for this day that the Lord has given to us. I will choose to rejoice and be glad in it. Please, as you join me, let's believe and pray as we want to hear God's word this morning. Our Heavenly Father, I want to thank you this morning. Thank you, Father, for a great weekend, and thank you, Father, for this beginning of the week. We just want to thank you so much for the gift of life. Thank you, Father, Lord, for even an opportunity, my God, to share your word this morning. Thank you for my viewers, and thank you so much, even as the Jonas King of Glory. You shall, dear Lord, Father, help us, even as we share your word. May this word, my Father, give us your revelation, and may it have understanding from you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you for watching us. I'll start by introducing myself. I'm Pastor Kelvin Songwa. I want to thank God so much. We've been having these sessions and, just a time that God has given us to share His word, and to me, such an opportunity. First and foremost, I want to thank all the Tuko viewers and even those who have joined us. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you even as you share. Thank you, Tuko family, for the love you've shown to me and my family. Thank you, everyone, even for the support, financial support, prayers, encouragement. I just want to thank you so much. May God bless you. And I just want to urge you, may you continue sharing this to your friends across the region, share widely so that we can continue helping each other and just sharing God's word together, because it helps us to grow and advance in the kingdom of God. And so this morning, I just want to encourage you. Today is a word of encouragement. And I'll start quoting the book of Psalms 23. The Bible says, "The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for His name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The Lord is my shepherd." My dear friend, the Lord is your shepherd. When the Lord is our shepherd, He says we lack nothing. There is nothing that we will not get because the Lord is our shepherd. And He says He makes us lie down in green pastures. God prepares pastures for us. He enables us to get what we require for our daily lives. And therefore, when we understand that the Lord is our shepherd, you see, a shepherd is someone who takes care of the sheep. And the Bible says, the shepherd, as he takes care of the sheep, he leads the sheep in pastures so that the sheep can get well and can be fed well. When the Lord is our shepherd, He is on our side. He is beside us. He goes before us. He guides us. And sometimes we might doubt the guidance of the Lord. We might doubt the shepherdhood of our Father. But He still reminds us that He is our shepherd. He is our Father. He is our strength. He is our refuge. Psalms 46 verses 1, the Bible says that the Lord is my strength and He is my refuge. He is my ever-present help in times of trouble. Are you in trouble? Are you feeling weak? Are you feeling, down? Are you feeling like things are not working out? I want to remind you this morning, the Lord is your shepherd. He says that you will lack nothing that is good. Praise the name of Jesus. He says that He will refresh your soul. Maybe you feel down. The Lord will refresh your soul this morning. Maybe you feel like, everything is not working out. You feel unwell in bed. You're feeling like everything, has just come. Everything has just, burdened me and burdened your life. But the Lord is your shepherd. Hallelujah. And He says, even though you walk through the valley of shadow of death. Look at this script.
Many times you walk through this valley, but even as you do that, you're not stagnating in the same place. You are just walking through it, and therefore you will get out of it. You will walk through it and you will come out successfully, because the Lord is your shepherd. And therefore, as you watch this morning and this, as we share God's word this morning, you might be there and just wondering, God, why have you left me? God, why am I downcast? God, why are things happening this way? Father, why is my marriage in this situation? Father, why are my children in this state? Why am I not advancing? Father, why is my wife and my husband or whatever is happening around you in this state? I want to remind you, your Father knows everything about you. Hallelujah. He knows it. He knows what you're going through. And today, I just want you to relax and rest in His promises. He has assured us He's our shepherd. You know, find peace in the Lord. Don't overthink. Don't think through much of this situation, because we find refuge in our Father. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. The Bible says in the book of 1 John 5:14 that this is the confidence I have in approaching God. Anything I ask of Him, He gives me. Anything I ask of Him, He provides for me. Praise the name of Jesus. And the Bible says again that whatever you ask of me, believe that you have received. Please believe in the Lord. He has given us assurance in this word. He speaks to us in a way that no one can speak to us, because He knows our weakness. He knows where we are troubled. He knows our shortcomings. He knows your weakness. Even right now, you might be guilty of something you did. You might be guilty of something that you undertook, which was not right. But I want to remind you, God loves you so much. You know, men can judge you. People can judge you on how you are. People can judge you on your state of life. People can judge you physically. But God is full of love. He will not disgrace you. He will not let you go beyond what you cannot bear. He has told us in His word, you know, even when you go through this temptation, you will not be there that you can't overcome it. He will give you the stamina, the strength, and the will to get out of it. Praise the name of the Lord. And you're wondering, how do I get out of this situation? The word of God is the promise that God has given to us. When we call upon Him, He hears us. When we seek Him, we shall find Him. Praise the name of the Lord. Isaiah 41 and verses 10, the Bible says, do not fear, for I am with you. Are you living in fear because of some things which have, you know, down on you? Are you feeling that because of this project that I have undertaken, I feel like I won't advance in it, or I feel like it's too heavy, or I don't have the financial muscle to undertake this project? God has everything in store for you. That project will succeed in the name of Jesus. No amount of the enemy, no amount of shackles of the devil that will be able to put you down. Remember, you are a daughter of Zion. Remember, you are a child of God. Remember, you have what it takes. He says that, don't you know you are a royal priesthood? You are a chosen generation. You belong to me. The Lord has given us all assurance. When we know who we are, we are able to advance in the kingdom like the children of the Most High God. Praise the name of Jesus. You're not just as any other person. God has given you such a very big responsibility. You have such a very big account in the kingdom, where you just need to go and get what belongs to you. Stop living in fear. Stop living in denial. Stop living in rejection. You have to step up and know you are the child of the Most High God. Hallelujah. The Bible says this, you know, just like the eagles mount up. God has given us that eagle anointing to mount up like an eagle. Young men get weary and weak, but those who trust in the Lord, He shall do what? He shall make them, you know, advance. He shall give them, you know, good blessings. He shall help them. He shall enable them. So you cannot be there. You need to know where you belong. Please, you know, dust off that challenge and walk in the way that God wants you to be. God has good plans for you. He says that, I know I have good plans for you. For I know, it is not something is doubted. For I know I have good plans for you. You see, God's word is confirmation. It is not something he's trying to think about. It's not something he's trying to, make or create. Already it is there. But sometimes we doubt in our hearts how God is able to assist us. I want to bring this word to you this morning, a word of encouragement. My dear sister, my dear brother, God has your back. You know, God has every reason for you to live. You can't be thinking suicidal. No, you can't. You can't. You need to know where God has placed you. You know, the Bible says that so he has highly exalted himself. You know, that at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord and Savior. He's our Savior. You know, troubles come and go. Nothing is permanent. Anything that comes to you will actually come to you as a test so that you can have a testimony. You know, you can't have a testimony without a test. When you've gone through so many tests, you are recording a testimony, and a very big testimony. Praise the name of Jesus. You've been trusting God for something, and years are going over and over and over, and you're wondering, will I ever achieve this? You know, time is going very fast, and you're wondering, God, where are you in this? Remember, the exam is always quiet during a test, and usually you'll find results coming. Your results are just yet to come, and you will see the goodness of the Lord. You know, when just like money, when you're troubled about money so much, money doesn't come to you. We know this is something that we know, all of us. But when you don't think so much about it, money just comes your way. We need to understand how God works. When you are troubled and you're in fear, that's when things don't work out. God does not work in fear. God does not work in complaining. God does not work in thinking too much and doubt. God works in easiness, in relax. And that's why he says, you know what? Understand who I am. Come to me. Bible says you shall eat the good of the land. Psalms 91 says that God will even send his angels concerning your situation. Don't you doubt who you are. Receive your rightful position and walk as a child of God highly, knowing that who you are. You know, sometimes you don't know who you are, you might be downcast. But you know who you are, you shall walk in victory. I have no doubt in my mind that the Lord is speaking to you today. I'm telling you, don't despair. I'm telling you, don't give up. You know, you're feeling like your job is going to get, you're going to lose your job. Don't fear. God has got your back. He is going to watch over his work to perform it. He made a way. You know, when Travis Green says, "You made a way," you know, when our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way. And I'm standing here only because you made a way. He's going to make a way because he's a way maker. God bless you this week. I pray that you're going to have a fantastic week. You're going to have a blessed week. Finish this month in the strength of the Lord. Finish this month with the stamina and the strength that God has given to you. You shall record a testimony. I want to pray with you. Maybe you are there feeling unwell, feeling uneasy, feeling rejected, feeling that things are going to break up, feeling like your marriage is going to split, feeling like you're going to go through a divorce, feeling like, your children are just, you know, not going to make it in whatever place they are. Maybe school fees, or they're not doing very well in school. Or you're feeling like things are so hard at this time. Or maybe you're watching us and you're in the bed in the hospital. And you're saying, God, can I get out of this place? I've been looking at, you know, these ceilings for so long because I am unwell. God is able to come to your situation right now. Believe with me as we pray this morning. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Wewe ni Mungu usiyeshindwa, usiyeshindwa, usiyeshindwa. Wewe ni Mungu usiyeshindwa. Father, in the name of Jesus. Indeed, you are God who can never be defeated in any situation. Father, I come before you with the prayer and with this promise you've given unto us. You have spoken highly about our lives. This morning, I speak about your goodness. Father, your word has confirmed to us that you're not a man who can lie. I pray, my God, this morning, there are many who are watching, my Father, and they're trusting you for a testimony. This morning, I come before you with your blessings and with your power. I pray, King of Glory, in every state that my viewers are watching, in every state that you are in right now, oh God, I speak a blessing. I declare and decree, may the anointing of the Holy Spirit come upon them. May you relieve them of the burdens, every chains of the enemy, every shackles of the evil, oh God. Today we dismantle them. We bring them under our feet in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I pray this morning, wherever place they are watching and they are in any trouble right now, by the name of the Most High God, I declare newness. I declare liberty. I declare freedom. My God, the enemy is a liar. Whatever you have spoken to them this day, it shall not have a way. Today, my Father, we receive freedom again. We receive your blessing. We receive your favor. We receive your grace again. Lord, I pray that remove every burden, remove every challenge, remove every weapon of the enemy. They are blessed now. We declare your promise, my God, that my God, you say when we approach you with confidence, we know you shall do it. Do it for them. Those who are well, receive your healing now in the name of Jesus. We proclaim the blood of the Most High God upon you now in the name of Jesus. We proclaim the power of the Holy Spirit that is coming upon you now to rescue from everybody. Receive peace, receive peace, receive peace in the name of Jesus. Receive your liberty and freedom. Be released from every slavery and from every bondage. You are a child of God, and now I declare you free from every work of the enemy. You are the child Most High God, and now God walks with you in every situation. You are blessed and never to be cursed. Today, your week shall flow well. You shall have a blessing. You shall speak of a testimony. Whatever you are expecting by now and the desires of your heart, in the name of Jesus Christ, may it come to pass. You are almost receiving promotion and things are not working out. Now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I declare in that HR office, may the Lord right now speak your name in the name of Jesus Christ. Receive that letter again. Receive that promotion in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you because today we shall declare of the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I give you praise and glory because we are blessed and we have received your goodness and your love. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. God bless you so much. Have a fantastic week. And God bless you as we meet again. Once again, Tuko family, God bless you. You know, friends, family, God bless you. Thank you everyone for tuning. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for the support. The Lord bless you. Until we meet again. Amen.